Probably is a camshaft that you've got.
Oh,
to,
there's some movement there.
Yeah, side to side play.
Yep.
And it's just a sign of the either a bush worn or the
or
the cam itself.
Cam itself, yes. Yeah.
Usually both to a certain degree.
Yeah.
So we'll inspect the cam when it comes out.
Yes. Yeah.
It's always worth inspecting the teeth. You never know when it's live. Perhaps something's come loose and chipped the teeth, or sometimes they complain of a noisy engine. Where it's,
they can make quite a bit of
just,
noise.
It can be just the teeth that are damaged.
Got a left-hand thread on the end of the crankshaft, of course, worth bearing in mind before you set about it with a hammer and chisel.
Yeah. Actually the wrong nut anyway.
Oh, right.
Should be a thinner nut than that.
Yes, that seems to be being thinner.
Let's see if that come off.
Yeah. Tricky thing to get off the pinion there if you don't have a puller.
Yes.
Just has little slots in the side. You can see this tool has been made up to fit into the slots. But without those, people tend to try and lever it off with a screwdriver or something in the slots, and that can easily break them, chip them, do all sorts of damage.
Or they'll split the cases with the gear still on, and then just keep hitting the end of the shaft.
You'll probably hear it as much as anything. But there shouldn't be any detectable movement like
I
don't think.
A thou and a half they recommend.
Yeah.
And with a thou and a half, you shouldn't feel
any
up and down or side to side movement there.
So down here, this is the oil pressure relief valve, and the idea of that is if the oil pressure builds up too high, that's not a good thing, same as blood pressure really. So you have a piston in here that opens up an oil way and just diverts the oil back into the sump at a given setting.
That's right.
The problem there can be, obviously, if you've got the wrong spring in that, it's the wrong weight, then you can be losing that oil pressure before you should be, or it can be too high.
Yeah.
So that's an important part as
and
well.
The oil pressure won't reach what it needs to be.
Yeah.
So it's not always... It's not always the bush or the pump.
Yes,
it can be the PRV.
Yeah. It's one of those parts that's very easily forgotten, isn't it?
It is.
That looks like that's one of your.
It is an SRM
one, valves,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, so at least
that will be checked.
Be okay. Check and, it, make sure it's still good.
Yeah. In general, they tend to be reusable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think your oil pump test rig has got a thing for that as well.
It does,
yeah.
So we can put that in as well.
Check those as well.
Check
sure
it against the pump that
properly.
We know is right.
That's good.
Yeah. Okay, so.
Okay. Gearbox next.
Get the gearbox out.
And here it is, all in
a
lump.
All in one piece. So we can strip that down after.
Yeah. Spring plunger that clicks through onto the cam plate here. This is what we'd call the gearbox cam plate, and the different shaped lines move the forks that hold the gear. So as that clicks through, it moves the gears forwards or backwards to engage with the next gear. One of the things that particularly started these off being popular with people, as I remember, is the fact that they had an oil drain bolt fitted with a magnetic plug. The original BSA one is just a steel cover. And to drain the sump, you had to take the whole plate off, which is okay, but it does mean new gaskets and all that. Whereas with this, you're able to just take the bolt straight out, drain the oil off, and refill it, and go and join your mates at the pub. And the magnetic plug just gives you a bit of an idea if there's anything horrible happening inside. Another little thing, though, it is very, very well worth taking this filter out from time to time and not being too lazy with that plug and just using that to drain your oil, because if you've got any problem going on with the big ends, it will always catch particles of big end bearings. So if ever you take this filter out and you see little silver shiny flecks, like little bits of chrome plating or little bits of electrical solder, that is very bad news. It probably means your big ends are going, really. So don't be lazy with this. It is actually quite a good little test of what's happening to your engine and gives you a bit of an early warning of disaster. Okay.
Saves you hammering.
Nice. Yeah, absolutely.
OK. Okay, there's one side. Washers from the other side. And you've got your oil seal and spacer.
Yep. That spacer works on the oil seal that's in here to keep the oil in the crankcase.
That's right. I wonder if we can see the... as you can. Of course, yeah, you can see quite a bit of damage there. Wear to there.
Yeah, that's actually pretty extreme. That,
it is, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I would imagine that's beyond being reused.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you can also see now the play
yeah.
in that main bush there. So.
Yeah, it's very unhappy. But you can see a huge ridge of wear on it in any case.
Oh, yeah, I mean, it's massively worn. In fact, if you were to measure the journal, you'd probably find that the journal's worn as well.
As well, yeah.
Yeah.
The situation with this main bearing wear that we spoke about before, one of the problems that typically tends to happen is that people have the big end bearings wear out. They'll replace the shells, but they won't think to look at that main bearing.
That's right.
And then lo and behold, it doesn't last long and it's gone again. So it's a thing of many parts, isn't it, really? It's not just one thing. Could be an oil pump fault. There's a lot of reasons. If your big end bearings go, it doesn't necessarily mean that's the only problem you've got.
I suppose I thought. But there is scoring in the big end journal.
Yeah.
So some debris has gone through
it. Yeah, that's dirty oil, isn't it, in that? I mean, I don't know about you, Matt, but to me that looks very like the kind of engine where somebody has replaced the shells and haven't replaced anything else.
That's right, really. You'd expect that much play to have worn straight down through the white metal.
Down to the copper.
Down, but
so that's a classic example of what we've just been talking about, sort of fixing the symptom rather than the cause. I don't know if you can see, but there's a kind of almost like a shot blasted look. It's quite dull silver. That really is a very keen indication of dirty oil. That should be a nice, smooth, shiny surface, possibly with the odd tiny little scratch here and there. It's not going to be perfect, but when it's got that hammered look to it, that's usually oil impurities. So it's quite possible this engine's been run without enough oil changes. As I run my fingernail across that, it feels like a ploughed field. You can feel a real lumpiness going over. It's almost like running your fingernail over an old record. So there's a lot of problem there. I guess it's worth just popping out the sludge trap and seeing what's going on in here.
Yeah, we'll see if we can get that out.
British and Princeton and the bikes have a centrifugal oil filter, which is the crankshaft itself. And oil comes in through this journal here on this engine, or through the end on the end fed ones. And as it gets into the main gallery that feeds the big ends, while the crank is spinning round, it flings any impurities to the outside. And they form a very hard, almost like wax, don't they, really?
Yeah.
Dry substance. And that's a good oil filter insofar as it's right before the big end bearing, which is the best place to put it. But the problem is it's buried deep inside the engine, and if it gets filled, you don't know anything about it. So whenever you have an engine down to crankshaft level, you really need to check inside there, make sure it's clean it out as required. So it's obviously one of your SRM type Allen headed
lights,
or somebody's,
it's something similar, but it's not ours.
Not one of yours?
No.
Oh, okay. The original ones just have a sort of a screwdriver
slot
in the end, which is quite difficult to get out, so the hexagon headed ones are a little bit easier.
I also have a slightly smaller hex.
Okay.
What else you can get this?
Oh, thought we're in luck with that one.
Yeah, usually it can be a bit of a
struggle.
Bit of a nightmare. It doesn't look too bad.
No,
well,
it doesn't.
It is dirty, but...
it's got dirt in there, but it's not... yeah, I mean, now these quite often be completely packed out with stuff, and you can see that it's a very, very black substance. It's
and
not a
gritty.
Nice... yeah, gritty as well. So, really, that kind of bears out what we said.
Yeah.
It looks like somebody's done the big end shells on it, probably cleaned this out at the same time and hoped to get away with it, but...
And quite often what they don't realise they need to do is to clean their oil tank out before they...
yes.
They'll drain the oil and they'll put new oil in, but they won't clean all
the
sludge out of the tank.
Yeah. Okay, well, we've got quite a lot of bits here that need some attention, so I think the next thing to do is we'll put them all together and start to have a look about what's going to be done to them.